In 1944, the US Marines were taking Guam back from the Japanese and stormed a large ridge. In the case of the Bunshu Ridge on Guam, some 830 service members were lost during this two-day battle to take this ridge. I mean, hundreds and hundreds of men died as they were trying to take this ridge. But not all the bodies of those service members were returned. Some dozen or so bodies that had never been recovered, people that are missing in action, that the US government is interested in returning, and their families are interested in returning back to the United States. Our mission was to go there and to use drone technology, use some of the technology that we use in our research, in order to investigate this battlefield that would help us provide information to where we might search for those bodies. There are many conflicts that occur in very remote locations with rugged terrain and lots of forests in them, especially in Southeast Asia, and occurs across the Pacific.
The terrain of Guam is fairly rugged, so what makes it particularly challenging is that its visibility is relatively low, you know, because it's thick vegetation. Even when you're on the ground, there's only so much that you can see at one time. It just takes an enormous effort to manually go in and search for things.
So we need to bring in technology to look at the landscape.
The biggest sensor that we use is a LiDAR sensor, so that's light detection and ranging. It shoots a laser out into the environment and collects that signature when it comes back, and by doing that it knows exactly where that laser hit in space. And it does that several hundreds of times per second. So if you fly the drone over in a pattern over the area that you're interested in, you build this 3D map of the area. And you capture information about trees, the ground surface, downed logs, foxholes, items of interest, and so find specific areas that are likely places that should be searched further on the ground. So it's really a combination between computational methods and archaeological methods.
Congress actually assigns resources to the DPAA, this agency, in order to fulfill that mission, to bring service members back. And that's what we're part of. We're part of this interest of the DPAA agency to go and look at battlefield conflicts where there's a lot of confusion. No one knows exactly where to look, and they need new tools to do that. And that's what we're bringing to this project, is using tools that we'd normally be using in archaeology and in geography into this sort of search for missing service members.
The technology and the methods that we're using to help solve this problem in Guam are part and parcel with other kinds of uses of this technology. There are so many applications to drones and LiDAR and photogrammetry.
And that is really exciting because we're able to sort of document details on landscapes across areas that were just impossible in any other way. So it's really sort of an exciting time technologically. So it's really great to be able to intersect, you know, interest in technology with research interests, and then of course the applied parts where we can actually contribute what we're learning here at the university into things that have societal impact.